Okay, Assalamualaikum. Dalam video ni, saya nak bincang tentang test bonding, test 2. So actually, in our SEM, we have two type of test for bonding. Part 1 and part 2. So this part 2 for standard level. Okay, so this is the answer for section A. For this video, I want discuss about the section A. I just want to proceed section B. Alright, for the section B, let's look at on the question number 1. Okay, draw the Lewis structure, state the shape, and predict the bond angles for the following species. Okay, so there are three chemical formula here. But for the question 1 and question 3, actually this is for higher level. So I just want to focus on the structure number 2. Okay, for the standard level, we just focus until 4 electron domain. Okay, so how to draw Lewis structure for sulfur chloride? The first step is you must calculate the number of valence electrons. Sulfur chloride. Sulfur has 6 valence electron plus 2. Chlorine has 7 valence electron equal to 7, 14, 6, 18 electron, or we have 9 pair electron. Okay, make sure the central atom is the most electropositive and terminal atom is the most electronegative atom. Okay, total we have 9 pairs. Now we have 2 pair. Okay, the third step is make sure the terminal atom achieve octet. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, there are one more lone pair, and the one more lone pair are located at the center. Okay, right. So sulfur chloride. Enam, tujuh, empat belas, empat belas, lima belas, enam belas, tujuh belas, lapan, sembilan belas, dua puluh. Okay, so the first step is you have to calculate the valence electron for sulfur chloride. Sulfur, 6 valence electron plus 2, 7, 7, 14, 6, okay, 20 electron, or we have 10 pairs of electron. Okay, so make sure the most electropositive located at the center or central atom, and the most electronegative become terminal atom. Okay, total we have 10 pairs of 10 pairs of electron. Now we have 2 pair. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, now make sure terminal atom achieve octet. Okay, 8. So there are 2 more lone pair and located at the central atom. Okay, so total is 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so this is our Lewis structure. Okay, right. So our Lewis structure, it doesn't matter. You can write at above and below and at bottom, or both of lone pair are located at the top of sulfur. Okay, either one, mana-mana pun boleh, because this is Lewis structure, not a geometrical shape. If geometrical shape, you have to put the lone pair at the exact position. Okay, now the shape. Okay, shape of sulfur chloride is band shape. Why band shape? Because this is tetrahedral. Okay, tetrahedral sulfur have one head one head and have three legs. Okay, so when it have two long pair, make sure it the head become long pair first, and then the second long pair either one for the leg. Okay, let's see. Okay, let's see lah, katulah yang hilang dekat sini. Okay, so kamu akan dapati dia akan berbentuk pen shape. Benda ni 3 dimension lah. So, bila kamu rotate, kamu akan nampak dia berbentuk jongkang-jongkit pen shape. Okay, sorry, dia bukan jongkang-jongkit, dia berbentuk V. Pen shape oleh another name is V shape. Okay, alright. Polar, polarity. Okay, how to identify the molecule is polar and non-polar? Okay, the simple step is, okay, please take note. Polarity. For the polarity, it can be two types. Okay, first symmetry. Okay, sorry. Okay, untuk the first type is polar, the another one is non-polar. Okay, macam mana nak tahu dia adalah non-polar? Non-polar dia mesti simetri. Apa maksud simetri? Simetri maksudnya no lone pair. No lone pair. Yang kedua, have same terminal atom. Same terminal atom. Terminal atom adalah surrounding atom. Okay, polar unsymmetry. Apa maksud unsymmetry? Bermaksud it have lone pair or have different terminal atom. Okay, different terminal atom. Okay, ini adalah cara yang mudah to identify the polarity. Okay, in this case, okay, look at the central atom, it have lone pair. When it have lone pair, meaning that this is unsymmetry. So when unsymmetry, okay, the unsymmetry, automatically it will become polar. Okay, alright, so polar. Okay, the next question. Okay, question number 2. Draw the resonance structure for nitride ion and its resonance hybrid structure. Okay, so there are two structure that student must understand how to draw resonance structure. Second, resonance hybrid structure. Okay, resonance structure bermaksud student mesti draw the most possible. As possible, as much as possible Lewis structure. Okay, so untuk nitrogen oxide, yang pertama sekali student mestilah tahu how to draw Lewis structure. So nitrogen dioxide ion, okay, yang pertama kira valence elektron dulu, 5 tambah 2, 6 plus 1 because gain elektron, kita dapat 6, 12, 5, 17, 18 elektron ataupun 9 pair elektron. Okay, jadi the most positive located at the center. Okay, 9. 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, and then bracket negatif. Okay, so student mestilah kira dia punya formal charge dahulu. Adakah ini the most preferable structure? For the oxygen, 6 minus 2, 4, 6, 7, negative 1. Nitrogen, 5 tolak, 1, 2, 3, 4, positive 1. So ni negative, positive, negative, tak ada kosong. Okay, the most balanced or stable molecule, the atom must have zero charge. Bermaksud apa negatif di sini? Negatif di sini bermaksud oksigen have tendency to donate in one lone pair to the central atom. Okay, jadi apa yang berlaku ialah dia boleh jadi begini eh. Oksigen, double bond, nitrogen, oksigen. Okay. Sekarang ni cuba kita kira balik berapakah formal charge eh. So, oksigen 6 tolak 2, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 0. Nitrogen 5 tolak 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. Betul eh? 2, 3, 4, 5. Sorry, 5. Okay, 5, 0. Okay, ni of course lah negatif. Negatif 0, 0. Okay, jadi struktur yang nombor 2 adalah stable. Paling stable because they have 2 atom inside the molecule that have 0 charge. Okay, bagaimanapun, dia juga boleh jadi macam ni. Kan, okay. Dan untuk proses yang ni eh, bila oksigen yang belah kanan ni the less stable, apa yang berlaku ialah dia akan ada tendensi untuk donate lone pair kepada central atom. Okay, bila dia donate kepada central atom, okay, apa yang berlaku ialah okay, dia akan jadi double bond. Dan lone pair dekat oksigen di sebelah kiri ni tadi, dia akan naik semula dekat oksigen tersebut, menyebabkan oksigen di sebelah kiri akan jadi single bond. Okay. Dan proses ini berterusan. Okay, berterusan. Di mana oksigen sebelah kiri pula akan donate lone pair kepada central atom. Dan one of single bond untuk oksigen belah kanan akan pergi kepada oksigen. Okay. Dan proses ini akan berulangan. Okay. So, untuk resonance, resonance you have to draw the much possible structure of Lewis structure lah. Okay, jadi dekat sini ada dua structure eh. So, oksigen, nitrogen, oksigen. Okay. This is resonance. Okay. Okay, ini adalah resonance. Okay, so how to draw resonance hybrid? Okay, this is resonance. Okay, resonance hybrid ialah okay, kita hilangkan lone pair. Hilangkan lone pair di mana oksigen tadi dia akan ada dekat salah satu macam ni. Okay. Apabila elektron tadi, elektron ni the always moving from left to the right. Okay. Yang ni eh, always move left to the right and then right to the left. Apa yang berlaku ialah double bond and single bond tadi akan jadi intermediate. Intermediate bermaksud dia ada single bond, dia ada akan satu garis putus-putus dekat sini. This is called intermediate. Okay. So cukup untuk ini sahaja for resonance hybrid. Tak perlu draw dia punya lone pair. Okay. Jadi tengok balik jawapan, ni adalah resonance hybrid. Okay. And then yang atas ni adalah resonance structure. Okay. Sekiranya kamu draw kedua-dua ni, akan dapatlah 1 mark and 1 mark. Okay. Make sure you all can understand lah. Next, okay, what is bond order of the nitrogen oxygen? Okay, what is mean by bond order? Okay, bond order. Okay, bond order make sure, okay, for single bond, bond order is 1. Bond order is 1. For double bond, bond order is 2. Triple bond, bond order equal to 3. Okay, for the intermediate, bond order is 1.5. Okay, apa yang kamu nampak dekat bond order? Bond order ni bermaksud, the stronger the bonding of covalent bond, the higher the bond order. Boleh nampak eh? Triple bond is more stronger. Or vice versa with the length. The shorter the bonding, which is triple bond, the higher the bonding order, bond order. Okay, so you have to memorize this part. Single bond bonding order 1, double bond bonding order 2, triple bond bonding order 3. For the intermediate, bonding order is 1.5. Okay, so need NO is 1.5 because this is intermediate if we refer on the resonance hybrid. Okay, comment its bond length. Okay, it is intermediate bond in between double bond and single bond. Yes, the length is in between single bond and double bond. Okay, the position of intermediate is here in between single bond and double bond, and the strength for intermediate also in between single bond and double bond. Okay, now look at the question 3. Ethane and CD silane are both hydride of group 4 with similar structure but different chemical properties. State which of the bond, silicon hydride and carbon hydride, is more polar. Okay, which one is more polar? So you have to calculate the electronegativity difference. Okay, refer on the data booklet. Okay, then when we calculate the, I think maybe they are it located on the section 8. Okay, I'm not sure, so, but you can refer on your data booklet related to the electronegativity difference. So when you calculate, you can found that the CH have electronegativity difference 0.4, SiH have electronegativity difference 0.3, meaning that CH is more stronger than SiH. Okay, so which one is more polar? The higher the electronegativity difference, okay, the more polar. Okay, so CH is more polar. Okay, so predict with an explanation the polarity of the two molecules. Okay, the two molecules, C2H6 and CiH6, which one is more polar? Okay, so actually you must understand how to draw the structural formula for carbon. It have six hydrogen, also same as silicon, it have 6 hydrogen. Okay, as I said before, how to identify the polar and non-polar? This is non-polar. Okay, why non-polar? Because both of them have same terminal atom, which is hydrogen. All terminal atom is same. Okay, second, no lone pair. Okay, sekiranya ada kedua-dua ni, dia adalah non-polar. Okay, alright. So this is the answer. Both molecule are non-polar because symmetry. Okay, because symmetry or dipole moment is zero. Okay, non-polar because symmetry. Yes, when it has same terminal atom and no lone pair, this is called symmetry. Okay, the next question. Graphite is used as a lubricant and it's an electrical conductor. Diamond is hard and does not conduct electricity. Explain this statement in terms of structure and bonding of this electrode of carbon. So this is under topic electrodes. So electrodes are the graphite, are the graphene. Okay, and the diamond, Okay, apa lagi? Graphite, graphene, diamonds, fullerene. Satu lagi fullerene. Okay, so yang ni dia tanya tentang graphite and diamond. Okay, apa yang kamu perlu explain di sini adalah explain statement in term of structure. So you must explain the structure and the bonding. For the structure, okay, for graphite it have hexagonal ring. Okay, kebanyakan pelajar sebut it have tetrahedral. It have tetragonal planar. Tetragonal planar is less accurate because graphite structure adalah begini. Ini adalah structure graphite. Okay. Di mana dia ada double bond. Okay. So, sambungan semua ni akan membentuk hexagonal ring. Okay. If we just focus on one type of carbon, carbon as a center, yes, this is tetrahedral. But, this is tetragonal planar. But tetragonal planar is less accurate. You have to say this is hexagonal ring. Okay. For diamond, yes, diamond has a tetrahedral structure. Tetrahedral structure. And then the term 2 is explained with on the bonding. Okay, so which one have the stronger bonding and weaker bonding? Diamond have strong covalent bond and graphite have weak covalent bond. Okay, weak covalent bond because it have for graphite it have weak covalent bond. Okay. Alright, untuk graphite ni, it has a few layer. Okay, it has few layer, and these layer are easily to slide each other. That's why the bonding is weak compared to diamond. Diamond cannot slide each other based on the carbon structure. And that's why diamond is more stronger in term of conductivity. Okay, so graphite have localized electron. Tengok ini. So this localized electron always moving. Okay, always moving. This localized electron have ability to carry electricity. So it have free moving electron. But for the diamond, there is no free moving electron. That's why it cannot conduct electricity. Okay. So don't get confused. Why carbon can carry electricity? Yes, because in graphite structure it have delocalized electron. Okay. Next question C, identify the type of intermolecular force. Okay. For me, it is more clear when you draw the structural formula. For the CH3 is Cl. Okay, this is polar bond. This is polar bond. That is why this is called dipole force. Okay, for London force CH. Okay, this is symmetry. Okay, actually this is non-polar bond. So when all the bonding is non-polar bond, okay, it will become London force. Okay, or London dispersion force. Hydrogen bonding, okay, CH. But it is OH. Okay, this one is hydrogen bonding. Okay. right. So when you correct all the number of bond, you will get 1 mark. Arrange the compound in order increasing relative strength. Okay, so you have to arrange from the weakest bond to the stronger bond. Of course, London force is the weaker. This one is London force, is the weaker force. And then dipole, dipole is intermediate, and hydrogen bond is the strongest in the intermolecular force. Okay, so that's all for discussion on test bonding.